Hello and welcome to Express Drives. Today I am spending my day with a motorcycle from a segment that led India to becoming the largest two-wheeler consumer in the world, commuters. The one I have here is the TVS Sport. So 125cc motorcycles are considered the ideal way of commuting, daily commuting in India. They are very fuel efficient and cost effective as well. However, as it turns out, my colleague Pradeep has quite a different perspective on what he thinks is an ideal way of commuting.
Well, my friend Abhilasha is being too optimistic here. While I'm not denying that whatever she said is not true, I think I have a better option here in the form of Honda Cliq. Now, don't get fooled by its timid appearance, as it has been built with a purpose and multiple things in mind. The Cliq is now the poster boy for affordable commuting, and it is primarily targeted at rural markets. As a cherry on top, it takes forward the USP of other Honda scooters, and it is also less hefty on the pockets.
What I've chosen for the scooter versus motorcycle battle is the TVS Sport. One of the sportier looking motorcycles in the segment, the Sport is powered by a 100cc engine which delivers a little over 7 bhp at 7500 rpm and is paired with a 4-speed manual transmission. It comes with a kick and electric start and is equipped with drum brakes at both ends.
My companion in this offbeat comparo is the Honda Cliq. The Cliq shares its 110cc engine with the segment leader Activa, and it has almost similar power and torque outputs at 8 bhp and 9 Nm. This one gets an easy electric start too, along with a host of other convenience features that make it a well-rounded package. While I think that my companion here is more practical and makes more sense, Abhilasha is in favor of her TVS Sport. So why waste any time when we can get head to the reality check? So Abhilasha, here's a challenge for you. Carry this box with you and reach the destination that I've sent you on your phone.
No, that's not fair.
That's totally fair.
Let's get on with it then.
Let's go.
Okay. I think I'll need help for this. Alright. And I'm off. Alright, I suppose you won this one fair and square.
I didn't just win. I'll tell you where all you have lost. A. You have wasted so much of time in tying that
bungee cord.
And second, you have sacrificed your pillion seat for that box. Pretty uncool, right?
That's true, but I'll tell you something. I may have wasted time tying down the box, but I suppose a motorcycle will always be a lot more agile through flicking through traffic. It's got larger wheels. You've got tiny wheels over there. So I suppose a bike will be a lot more agile through traffic.
Yes, the wheels may be tiny, but this one has got tubeless tires, so you don't need to worry instantly in case of a puncture, which clearly your TVS Sport does not have. Also, this one comes with knobby tires, which is not a marketing gimmick, and these actually work well in case of broken surfaces, and such roads are actually very common in rural localities.
Well, I'll have to give it that. I mean, tubeless tires are quite a necessity. I mean, they do take out a lot of stress in case of a puncture. I mean, you can, you know, roll the bike, the motorbike to the nearest puncture fixing place. So that, yes, given that, but what the TVS Sport handles well is speeds above 70 kilometers an hour. And why I say that is I've ridden both these machines, and since you've got knobby tires, which are great for off-road, by the way, and I speak from experience, the time I rode it in Jaipur was in Chokidhani, and it was loose sand everywhere. And the Cliq did handle it quite well. I am not happy saying all this.
So you admit it finally.
Right? Yes. Whose side am I on? Anyhow, so on a TVS Sport, you go above speeds 70, 80, it remains quite stable. And that's what I'm sold on for this motorcycle, for the motorcycle segment actually, because on scooters I do feel a little wobble coming on speeds which are above 80.
Well, the Cliq might not go as fast as your TVS Sport, and I may lag behind a few meters. Here is a sure thing. I can sacrifice on the speed factor for a better comfort, and yes, the seat height. The seat height is just 743 mm, so almost everyone can ride it without any difficulty.
Yeah, that's true. Well, I suppose you do get better comfort, and the Cliq is, you know, the kind of motorbike that any rider can ride. But I have this one thing, very important thing to talk about, which I have saved for the last one, is fuel efficiency. And the TVS Sport, the claimed fuel efficiency on this bike, what TVS says, is 95. But realistically speaking, it will be somewhere about 70 to 75, which gives you a range of about 850 kilometers on one full tank. Now let's talk about the Cliq. It's got a 3-liter fuel tank, and the fuel efficiency which is claimed is 60. Realistically, let's bring it down to 50. So you get somewhere about 150 to 180 kilometers of fuel range.
Yes, I agree on that. But well, for those 180 kilometers, I can accommodate my luggage on the floorboard and under seat storage. I can be more comfortable, and I don't have any hassle handling a scooter which is just 102 kgs.
Well, I suppose this argument is getting somewhere. It also depends on the kinds of, you know, needs you have, what you expect from a motorcycle. So I don't think, a young school pass out to get one of these, they'll probably want something more peppy to look at.
Right.
So yeah, it's also a different perspective on what a buyer wants from a motorcycle or a scooter. So there are positives and negatives for both kind of motorbikes we have here. So pick one based upon what you expect from a two-wheeler as a buyer. If you are looking for stability on speeds above 70 kilometers an hour, better handling through traffic, and an enormous range on one full tank of fuel, go for the motorcycle.
On the other hand, if you want comfort, storage space, and are one of the lazy ones who don't want to change gears every now and then, the Cliq or any other scooter for that matter can be a good option for you. I second my friend Abhilasha that while a scooter may not offer you that generous range or easy flickability in traffic, it will surely not disappoint you in other parameters.
So, well, the motorcycle does have efficiency on its side. I mean, about 850 kilometers on one full tank, but I will have to admit the scooter offers a lot more practicality with the luggage space, a USB charger. So yeah, it does make sense.
So in the end, probably it will be safe to say that I and the Honda Cliq have won this battle.
I didn't want to hear that, but yes, I suppose.
Sad but true.
Find this video helpful? Put a like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
For more auto news and reviews, visit www.expressdrives.com. Thank you so much for watching.